St. Louis 3-1 on the year. The Hawks are 1-2-1 as we get ready for this divisional battle. We told you Nikolai Habibulin with the call tonight. Look at that save percentage. Very solid at 92 in his first two appearances of the year. Opposed tonight by 35-year-old Manny Legacy. This guy's going to be busy. Their other goalie, Chris Mason, just had an emergency appendectomy. So Legacy is going to be carrying the load. He's had 50 wins, Legacy, in 2 years here in St. Louis. Eric Furlatt, Kevin Pollock, the officials, Brad Lazarowicz, Johnny Murray are the linesmen.
This first period is brought to you by your local Hyundai dealer. What a day for a Hyundai. Go to mychicagohyundai.com.
Jonathan Toews and Patrick Kane with Chris Versteeg opening up for Joel Quenneville. The Andy McDonald line on the ice for the Blues. We're underway. McDonald to the backhand, cutting in. Didn't get anything on that shot, but a good rush developing quickly for St. Louis.
A quick little change here on defense. Right off the opening faceoff, Brian Campbell made a quick change. He's paired up with Aaron Johnson, and that allowed the Blues. Duncan Keith jumped on the ice, and that allowed the Blues the opportunity to get an odd man situation there. But Habibulin giving up no second chance opportunity.
McDonald got the draw to the boards, and now it's cleared in behind. Andy McDonald there. Dave's waiting to see which way he's going to go. McDonald tried to throw it in front. Just bounced away from Boys. Now out to the line. Hillebout wagon with a long shot. Tip. Good save and a redirect by Habibulin. That was a tough chance in traffic on a puck to change direction. The Blackhawks finally get back to the other end. The long wrister by Versteeg, handled by Legacy. Game rebound. They score. The first shift of the game for the Hawks. Patrick Kane on the rebound. And 40 seconds in, 1-0.
Well, after the big stop by Nikolai Habibulin, the Hawks get control of the puck, and Chris Versteeg just throws it to the net. But Eric Brewer, I'm not sure what he was. Obviously, he didn't see where this puck was. And then Patrick Kane went hard to the net. Just get yourself to the net. Goaltenders give up rebounds. And Patrick Kane puts the puck in the back of the net. Big save by Habibulin. A simple play by Versteeg and hard work by Kane to get to the net.
And Chris Versteeg, who had two assists in the last Hawk game. What do you always hear? It's never a bad idea to get the puck to the net. That's a poor rebound given up by Legacy, but you'll take him however you can get him. Now Tkachuk deep in his own end for the Blues. And a long pass to Flex. Finally to Havlat, dropping to Campbell. Havlat able to kick to the stick nicely, and then he'll circle back with it. The Hawks look to maintain possession. Campbell will be forced to dump this one, and the Hawks will look to complete a change. Barrett Jackman is back for St. Louis. Paul Kariya. His pass intended for Oshie, who didn't have a stick on the ice, and the puck eventually dumped in. Oshie took it away. DJ Oshie looking to go back to the line. A long shot, never got to the net. Oshie works against Keith. Now Perron spins to his backhand. David Perron, who had a pretty good rookie year for the Blues here last season, tried to center that one off the mark, though, and Jack Skilly comes out, fighting through a hack with a long wrist shot, and Legacy steered it in behind. Now the puck taken back by the Blues, and Perron bounce it to center where Pollock could get no further, greeted by Keith. But it squirts loose. Here's McDonald cutting in right into the breadbasket of Habibulin.
Well, after the dismissal of head coach Denny Savard and Joel Quenneville taking over, a lot of question marks of who would be in goal after the win the other night. And talked to Joel Quenneville about that in between the win against Phoenix and here tonight. And he watched the game, was thoroughly impressed with the way that Nikolai Habibulin, and again, making mention, Pat, of it's only his only played two games in the last 6 months after missing a lot of training camp and no exhibition games as well. He thought he was really sharp and gave the Hawks a chance to win that game after a slow start in that first period.
Adam Burrish will push it in. Ben Eyre able to arrive first in behind. And a long along the boards. A long wrist shot by Frazier, never got through. High note. Got help from Jackman, and he's able to clear the zone. Now Weaver going rink wide to Jackman. Weaver. Got help from Jansen to dump it. Bobby Bullen brings it around the boards as the Blues are completing a change. And the Hawks able to get it in. Versteeg chasing his own dump, and he got to it. Chris Versteeg leaves it in behind. Patrick Kane got spun around, but Tave kicks to the stick. Tried to center. In tight was Keith, but he had the puck bouncing as it arrived. And that allowed Legacy to smother.
Puck support, outstanding job here early, especially for this line, the line that got the first goal of the game. Support down low. He called every forward's name there, Pat, on this shift. Versteeg started, Kane supported, Taves was right there, and who jumps into the play but Duncan Keith? Great support here early for the Hawks in the offensive zone.
Now Duncan Keith, the last game had two assists in a rare 27 minutes of ice time. I say rare because that's a light load for him. Keith leaves it for Seabrook, had no stick to play it with, gloved it to the boards. Seabrook able to regain the cue. They try to pry it out of the corner. And the Blues hold it in. Brewer shot it in behind the net. They'll peel off for a change, and Keith will try to allow the Hawks to make a change of their own. That happens. A pass from Bufflin, a touch pass to Sharp. He chased it down. Patrick Sharp brings it around. Havlat faked a pass, walked in front. He's rink wide picked off, though. And out comes Tkachuk. Three are back for the Hawks. A dump in, chased by Backus, but he couldn't maintain control. And the Blackhawks come out. Havlat looks for Dustin Bufflin, who had hit six hits in the last Blackhawk game. Now forced the puck loose. Havlat with Bufflin to the front of the net. Here comes Campbell's long shot off a leg. And Sharp came up with it, but his shot never got to the goal. And the Blues could only get as far as center. Big hit there by Bufflin on a Weaver.
Good active stick there by Aaron Johnson right before that hit by Bufflin, Pat. That allowed Bufflin to step into Weaver on those boards.
Aaron Johnson singled out by a couple of his teammates for a game-changing type hit in the last victory against Phoenix the other night. And another physical play in behind by Ladd. Let the Blues come out. Oshie looks to center. Good coverage by Skilly. And now a collision with Seabrook and Oshie, and Brent Seabrook came up with the puck, but failed to get it out. Now they battle loose in behind Skilly. Couldn't get it away from Oshie. He spins to his backhand. TJ Oshie against Jack Skilly. Now Perron dug it out. But Skilly's in his way. Oshie now against Keith. They've got Kariya in the slot area, but he is well covered by the Hawks. Now the puck came to him, and from a tough angle, his shot deflected out of play.
I'm going to go back to that last shift for Chris Versteeg, Jonathan Taves, and Patrick Kane. Here's Chris Versteeg in behind the net. And there you see Patrick Kane. Now stop it right here. Watch Jonathan Taves. Watch the support. He comes down low. You already saw Versteeg. There's Kane, and here comes Taves. And then on the backside, there goes Duncan Keith for an offensive opportunity. So again, help out the guy down low. Lots of communication, support one another, and create some offense.
Alan Frazier's backhand deflects, and Hendry carried on. Hit hard as he dumped it in, sandwiched by two Blues. Brewer and high note, the centering attempt. Deflected right through the crease, now at the side of the goal, they hack and whack. It squeezes to the corner where Stasny is checked by Burrish, who's on the deck. Adam Burrish, got help from Ben Eager. Ben Eager's pass deflects to Jordan Hendry. His long wrister blocked. And then Hendry delivers a blow to Jansen, who did get it out. And some physicality here the last two or three shifts both ways. Now the Blues, Jackman, former Rookie of the Year, will chase his own dump in. Duncan Keith. Gave it to Brent Seabrook. The left side and Kane. Looks back towards Seabrook. That's gloved out of midair. Now a long lead counterattack pass, but offside was McDonald, and the whistle sounds. A big save by Habibullin at one end, a goal by Patrick Kane at the other, and it's 1-0. .438 career victories for that man. There are only 16 coaches in the history of this league that have had more.
Taking over for Denny Savard.
I think it's going to be quite a while, Eddie, before there's enough familiarity. I mean, he's trying to put names and faces together right now, which is, remember the old story about Billy Ray years ago and the Boston Garden, you know, who's number 19? Well, that's Eddie Westphal. No, on our team.
Good thing their name's on the back of the jerseys now.
That's an offside play. Eddie talked a moment ago about the goaltending situation. It's been a question all training camp long, and how does Joel Quenneville expect to use his two netminders?
Well, I'm going to approach it, let it play itself out. I think both guys want to be that guy. Both guys want a bulk of games. Both guys have been able to do that. And, you know, we're comfortable that both guys are capable, and right now it's up to me. And I think we're just going to let it evolve right now and see how it plays out. But I don't like changing the winning hand. And I think Habby's coming off a real strong game, so we'll give him tonight.
And you have to expect that, at least to some degree, that's going to be the case for virtually every position, but at the most important position, well, that question remains at least a little bit up in the air.
And his track record over the last 4 or 5 years has been pretty consistent. I mean, he'll ride the guy that is doing the job and get a good feel for it, and the bottom line is getting that guy in a routine and letting him go with it.
You win, in all likelihood, you're in. We approach the midway point of the first with the Blackhawks owning a 1-0 lead on Patrick Kane, second of the year. Versteeg trying to jam it loose on the end boards. Kane then did. Taves front of the net. Kane could not get it through a skate. And a near blowout for Oshie, but he maintained possession of it. And the puck cleared out to center.
Boy, he's been all over the ice here early for the St. Louis Blues. Former teammate of Jonathan Taves at North Dakota, TJ Oshie.
Oshie's rink wide is picked up by Perron in on Seabrook. Trying to fend off a check, looking to center. It deflected to Kane. He's able to hoist it to the neutral zone. And Keith is first out of the zone, dumping it into the Hawks' change. That's Roman Pollock behind the Blues net.
Who's the referee tonight? Pollock?
Kevin Pollock. I don't know if Pollock's going to ever call a penalty on Pollock, but it could happen.
Fans want an opportunity to sit in between the player benches during a Hawks home game? Well, now you can. Bid on the new CBOE seats through the online CBOE seats auction. Visit www.chicagoblackhawks.com for more info. Chicago Board Options Exchange is proud to be the presenting partner of the Chicago Blackhawks.
Pollock dumped it in. He almost hit Pollock with it, but did not.
Please, we had enough laughs before the game started with that.
They're going to play it back to Legacy. Ladd absorbed a hit, but able to keep the puck alive, but it finally squirts loose, and Andy McDonald. And now Keith had a blowout, but the pass did not connect with Boys, who's hit hard by Seabrook, coming across to help his partner. Three are locked up in behind the net. Porter couldn't come up with it. Skilly did. Bolin got it out.
Good support there defensively by Jack Skilly.
Now Brewer back into the zone, has no help as the Blues were changing. And Duncan Keith fires a long pass behind Bufflin. Then he picked it up. Bufflin centered. Here's Sharp. Big save by Legacy on a good chance for Patrick Sharp. And he's got the puck again. Sharp. 42 minutes the last two games, two goals and an assist, and a plus two over that stretch. Now a long shot, tip deflected wide on a Bufflin redirect. Held in by Campbell. Walks to the middle with a long clip shot up off the glass. And Legacy badly in need of a whistle after a very good shift for the sharp line. And the Blues trying to stir things up after the whistle. There's a bit of a confrontation right around the blue paint, but the officials there and the players begin to calm down.
Time now for a Buick Pontiac GMC drive to the net and go back to the goal of the game. There's Patrick Kane, but watch him keep moving his legs through the neutral zone. He doesn't stand and watch Chris Versteeg. He keeps moving. Now he sees a loose puck and puts the puck past Manny Legacy. So a lot of good things happening there on our drive to the net by Patrick Kane. And Pat continued to talk about it. And he tried to teach young hockey players, guys without the puck, is as important as a guy with the puck. If he dogs it through the neutral zone or gets straight-legged, never an opportunity towards the net.
That line is out there again. And here come the Blues. McDonald rolled it to the corner. Campbell against Correa there. Good puck support from the Hawks. And they start back. Aaron Johnson pushed it in. It's four skaters aside after coincidental minors to Tkachuk and Sharp. After that last confrontation, here's Campbell looking to center. Went right through the blue paint. And McDonald will settle it down for the Blues. Correa trying to break away. He's got the puck. It's rolling. Comes in. Shot it wide. He never did get that thing settled down. And the Hawks look to move back in, but Campbell was offside.
Well, a quick little outlet. McDonald to Correa, and as you mentioned, Pat, puck never settling down, but looked like to me that Paul Correa hurried this. He knocked it out of midair. Great job of knocking that down. Looked like he had a little bit more time to move in on Nikolai Habibulin and felt the pressure of Aaron Johnson from the backside.
Seabrook stripped of it by Oshie. McKeith has it back. Havlat has been wonderful the last couple of outings for the Hawks. Two goals, two assists, and Havlat shot here deflecting out of play.
Well, the Hawks will take on the Vancouver Canucks tomorrow night. The first 10,000 Blackhawk fans will receive a welcome back Pat Foley pin, courtesy of the fine folks at AT&T. Good seats are still available for this game. Don't miss a minute of action. Welcome back Pat Foley pin. Remember, you promised me couple of them. Are we included in the first 10,000 tomorrow?
Yeah. If Diana wants one, she can have one. I don't know about you. All right, here's Bolin shooting right into the bread basket.
Lots of room, 4-on-4. Responsibilities of the forwards are the other team's defensemen, so there's no miscommunication at all on the ice. D have forwards, forwards have D, and that's it. That's a message that'll come from the coaches behind the bench to the players. Got that open ice jumping into play, especially with guys on the back end, Pat, like Duncan Keith, like Brian Campbell. They're going to be able to jump into those plays, turn those two-on-twos into three-on-twos, or maybe one-on-ones into two-on-ones, and pick in their spot. And if that happens, the forwards have to fill in for those guys back on the other end.
By the way, speaking of messages, I'm sure one of the most firm messages passed along in the Blackhawk locker room before this game. We haven't talked about it yet, but you can't take any penalties against this group. Wow, this power play for the Blues has been electric.
Smoking.
They've gone 9 out of 18 with the extra man. Here's a long shot off the mark, and Habibulin will play it off the end boards. And the power play at home for the Blues has been even better than that. 6 out of 10 here in their own rink. So Andy Murray's group has been making a living by way of the power play. We said 3 of the 4 games they've played, they've scored 5 goals or more.
I think one thing, talking to Keith Tkachuk before the game about their power play, Patty, so they haven't been predictable. Last year they were pretty predictable. They'd run the same play on the right side of the boards where McDonald and Correa would spin themselves into submission and just keep doing the same thing over and over and over again. They're just not being predictable. Should be offsides here. Yeah.
Lots of movement on it. In fact, Murray and one of their units has often used 5 forwards. So they've had a great start with that special team. And here we are 12 and a half minutes in and only a couple of coincidental minor penalties. So good work by the Hawks to stay out of that scenario.
And trust me, word gets around, even though it's early in the season. You read the game notes, you hear about the power play being so effective early. So again, I mean, you're going to take penalties, but you want to make sure they're good ones. You don't want to take any selfish ones or put yourself behind the eight ball. And to this point, it's been great.
High note shouldered Hendry right to the deck. Puck is held in by Jan Stasny. Brings it around for Dan Hynote in his first game of the year. Coming off an injury, but this one taken away by Burrish. He was then checked. And Brett Sopel able to find Ben Eager getting it out. Hawks wanting to change. Tkachuk steams back in. One against three. Squeezes to the corner. In behind it goes to McClement. Jay McClement leaves it, and Tkachuk wants to get the puck to Backes, who dropped it to Brewer. Brewer into the corner, tried to center. That was blocked and cleared out.
Hawks got to be ready in the defensive zone. It looks like the Blues are starting to activate their defense a little bit more when they have possession. Hawks have done a good job to this point, Pat, of not allowing constant pressure and allowing that puck to go from low to high. So keep an eye on the Blues defenseman jumping into those holes in the Hawks defensive zone.
Now Aaron Johnson will go off the glass safely with this one. He's not going to have it go far enough for icing. So the Blues start back. Wagner to Correa. Now to the right side. Here's Oshie, had his head down, and it was mostly able to avoid the hit attempt from Johnson. Puck went off the side of the net, and Kane able to win a board battle, and the Hawks come out because of it. Patrick Kane gains the line. Try to drop it to Taves. He spins to his forehand as the Hawks were changing. And Taves still with it. Now Seabrook to Keith. His long blast didn't get through and bounce out of play. Now to the late moments of the opening frame, and the Blackhawks are in front.
Time for our Harris Bank check replays, and yeah, there's been a little rough stuff. Not surprising. Hawks and Blues giving and receiving. Just the holidays are right around the corner, partner. So lots of Hawk fans. Ran into a couple Hawk fans last early evening walking through downtown St. Louis.
There often are quite a few in this arena. Fight for it in the corner, and McDonald able to dig it loose. Seabrook to Keith. He's got time to take a look and finds Taves. Jonathan Taves. Push it in behind the net, colliding there with Jackman. Four players battle. Sports toward the goal mouth. The Blues on it, and Brad Boys made a good pass. McDonald had it broken up before reaching Porter. And Versteeg, the old man on this line at 22. Has a little problem here with Boys. And a good recovery by Keith to prevent a shot. Boys still has it, though. Trying to go through the goal mouth. Didn't get it to Stasny. Jan Stasny with it now. A long wrist shot and a save by Javi Bulin. Rebound bounce high to the air. And McKee rings it around. Now they get to it in the corner. Then Pollock held it in. Backes, back of the net. David Backes, who toiled in Peoria for a couple of seasons. Now high note. And then it shot back around to the corner, and a pinching McKee is in deep. He got the puck and then ran into his own man. Backes zigged when he should have zagged. And finally the Hawks get it out of there.
Long shift for Duncan Keith and Brent Seabrook. They were not allowed to get off because of good work by the St. Louis Blues.
Now they get back into the zone. Pollock put it behind the net. Backes left it there, but Aaron Johnson took it back, fires it out of the zone. 3.5 to go in the first. A 1-0 Chicago lead. And Joel Quenneville's coaching debut. Perron checked by Johnson. And it's picked up by Skilly. Oh, and his pass was there, but jumped away from Bolin. Now Skilly Fought through a check in behind. He then was greeted by McClemmon, and the Blues get the puck out of the zone.
But Paul Kariya wasn't expecting that play. He was just shooting straight up the ice and never looked back to see where that puck was coming. And I think if he would have taken a quick look, he just had to make a quick turn, Pat, and he would have had that puck right on his stick.
Now it's cleared up the boards, and Hawks keep it in. Boland going rink wide. Sopel, oh, he tried to put a pass, but it's behind Ladd. And the Blues start back. Here comes Perron into the zone. Left it, Kariya. Here's the drive. High and wide. Put it on the glass. Weaver attempted to keep it in, but the Hawks now have possession. Controlled now by the Blues, and Barrett Jackman. But his pass broken up. Seabrook looks for Burrish, who was well covered. McDonald dropped it back to McKee, and then Andy McDonald. He's a salary cap casualty in Anaheim, but a two-on-one on a counterattack. Here's a drive. Burrish into the glove, out of the glove. Oh, Legacy coughed it up. But the referee had lost sight of the puck, so the whistle sounded.
Well, a turnover by Andy McDonald, trying to split three Blackhawk forwards. Not a good thing to do, and an Adam Burrish, good idea there. Gets the pass from Frazier. No chance to give it go. Legacy well out. As you mentioned, Pat, quick whistle there because the referee lost sight of the puck, and which he's supposed to do. What a good opportunity.
Now the draw to Kane. Here's the wraparound, and Legacy got to the post in time. The Blues are going to get a penalty. Bouncing puck. Havlat with a backhand shot, deflected up high. Now Kane with it. His rink wide taken by Johnson. Six attackers for the Hawks. Bouncing puck in the slot. Now a shot up the side of the goal from Kane. Kane picked it up in behind, was checked. Finally, Brewer got control of it, and the Hawks with a late power play in the first.
Some good opportunities. And that was all off the faceoff, Pat. It was a 50-50 puck off the faceoff. Go back to the last game against the Phoenix Coyotes. The Hawks won 67% of the faceoffs. And it's puck possession. And it was one of those 50-50 pucks. And that man right there, Patrick Kane, jumped to the loose puck and was able to get behind the net. And then all of a sudden there was some chaos and disarray for the St. Louis Blues. And that ended up causing the penalty to Eric Brewer. So good job all the way around. And sometimes people think, Pat, it's just a formality, a face-off. Well, if you win the puck, you dictate what the heck happens. But if you lose it, you got to go get it. And the Hawks did a good job of that.
Versteeg, Boland, Havlat in front of Keith and Seabrook. Open up the power play. Dave Boland in behind to Chris Versteeg, who's checked by Jay McKee. Now the puck deflects out to Duncan Keith. Martin Havlat tries to go back to Keith, but it went off a leg. Seabrook tried to hold it. Jackman got it back cleared into the final minute now of the first. Hawks are 1-for-19 with a man advantage so far this season. And the one they got was on a two-man power play. Backus going to have some space. The drive out was Javi Bullen, well outside the crease to challenge that attempt. Take a look at our U.S. Cellular question, the text question of the night. Who's going to win the season series? Text your answer to 94597.
Last year, the Hawks winning 5 of 8. Now with the schedule change, you only play the teams in your division. Hawks will play the teams in the Central 6 times each.
Off the draw, an attempt. Ryan McClement was a little off the mark. And Keith leads him up the ice slowly. Taves had a little problem handling it, and it'll be shot back the other way. Down Down to five ticks remaining as Jonathan Toews tried to dump it, but that will bring us to the end of the first period. So a very energetic frame for the visiting Chicago Blackhawks, and Joel Quenneville's team will take a lead into the opening intermission. Patrick Kane's goal, the difference.
Blackhawks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Toyota. Get saved by zero at your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, moving forward. U.S. Cellular, believe in something better. Harris Bank, we're here to help. And by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise.
Welcome back to St. Louis. The Hawks lead 1-0 over to St. Louis Blues. Well, for a limited time, you can still get in on Chicago Blackhawks season tickets that include the opportunity to purchase tickets for, yes, the Winter Classic on New Year's Day at Wrigley Field. Call 312-455-7000 or visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com.
Our second period tonight brought to you by IPA. And this Jonathan Toews line, very, very effective in the first. They scored the game's only goal. Toews on the ice for about 6.5 minutes. Marty Havlat, the forward leader, 7 minutes of ice time for Havlat for the Blackhawks. And a very short man advantage here. Remember a late first period penalty to Brewer, a half minute of power play time awaiting the visitors right now. Ryan Campbell, whose workload was a little bit less than it often is in the first period tonight. Carried on by Kane. He couldn't quite stick handle his way through all the traffic. Sharp looks for Kane in the corner. A ring around for Campbell. Just a backhanded back up the boards. Touch past the front. Good active stick by Legacy. Otherwise, Buckland would have had him one-on-one. And four players pile up in behind. The penalty over now. Both teams at full strength. Kane to Campbell. And that puck was rolling as it got to Keith. Now Kane sweeps it to Keith with a long shot and a save by Legacy. Jackman failed to get it out. Puck bouncing around and finally the Blues get control of it. And the Hawks will head for a change. The Blues do as well. Everybody waits for that to happen, and finally it's dumped into Chicago territory. Keith made a nice pass. Boland comes away. Now Havlat going rink wide to Seabrook. His shot and a save by Legacy.
Well, we made mention in the first period, Pat, about opponents tonight, but teammates back at college. The alma mater of Troy Murray. Analyst on the radio side on WGN AM 720, and there TJ Oshie and Jonathan Toews celebrating a goal. And I asked Toews about Oshie and says he never gives up on plays. That's the one thing that he did in college, is he never gives up on plays. And asked Oshie about Jonathan Toews, and a pure competitor were the words he used to describe Jonathan Toews.
Bouncing puck in front. Good stick by Keith. He prevented a headache for his goaltender. Duncan Keith able to tie up a stick right on the doorstep. Seabrook for Havlat. Chipped it up the boards. This one held in at the line by Wagner. Duncan Keith again looks for Havlat. This goes out of the zone. Wagner back with it. And now Perron gave it to Tkachuk. A wrist shot handled by Javi Bulut. Keith pushed it into the neutral area. And the Blues, Oshie gains the line. DJ Oshie trying to get away from Seabrook. Now Oshie rolled it back. Here's Jay McKee. A long flip shot hit traffic. Just bounced out of Oshie's reach. McKee kept it in. And Perron Looked after by Keith, then Tkachuk in there as well. A pinching McKee to the corner. And now Ben Eager. And his pass deflect out of the zone.
Got to be sure there. Soft play in the high slot area. And Eager and the Hawks dodged a big bullet there. Got to make sure that puck is going hard.
McClement chased in behind the net, picked it up. Hey, McClement leaves it in the corner. Now David Backes pulls up, goes to the line. Weaver's long shot never got to the net. And the Hawks come away, two against two. Ben Eager has been out there for a while. Eager, in the last game, had six hits in only 8 minutes of play. Talk about effective ice time. Now, the Blues out of their end, but could only get as far as center. Patrick Kane to Brian Campbell. Three are back. A long shot. He scored! Patrick Kane set up Brian Campbell, who snapped a 40-foot wrist shot right by the glove. A legacy, 2-0.
Well, the speed of Brian Campbell coming through the neutral zone. Good job of settling that puck down. And Jonathan Toews almost went offside, but once he realized there was a little bit extra of a stick handle, I don't know if that went off defenseman Eric Brewer or not, but a quick wrister by Brian Campbell. Good pass there by Patrick Kane. Just not dumping it in, giving it up, taking a look, and then here comes Campbell really slicing through the defense of the St. Louis Blues. But a quick wrist shot beats legacy.
All right, now it's clear to the Hawks line. Havlat looks for Bufflin. Chasing in on Weaver. Dustin Bufflin didn't get much on that pass attempt. Kariya comes back. A give and go finds Kariya, spinning it loose, but the pass deflected back out of the zone. Dustin Bufflin also had six hits the other night against Phoenix. Out, Jonathan Toews dropped it back, and here's Brent Seabrook. And Kane gets it into the zone. It bounced toward the goal mouth, and Legacy sweeps it away. Jansen in for Hinote. Hawks are going to get an interference penalty on that dump in, and this vaunted hot Blues power play will get its first chance. Maybe that's a confrontation after the fact. Hinote and Toews were first involved. They now separate.
Well, you had a mismatch there, Pat, in favor of the Hawks. You had the fourth line out there for the Blues against the Toews, Kane, and Versteeg unit has been really good here. It's 25 minutes of play. Well, Pat, you made mention of it a little bit earlier in the second period. Duncan Keith made a great play of just tying up the stick of Andy McDonald. Simple play. And go back to the first period. Brent Seabrook got in behind and he just lifts up the stick of Brad Boyes at the last second. When you're a defenseman in front of the net, you just can't be standing there with your stick in the air. You got to have a purpose. Tie up the stick so not allow the player to get an opportunity towards the goal.
A Duncan Keith interference call gives the Blues their first power play tonight. We told you they've been great this year, but 6 out of 10 at home on the power play. Now McClement had it taken away. They'll have to chase back.
Good read there by Jordan Hendry.
Kariya pushed it into the zone. Boyes' pass went off a leg. Then Versteeg had a blowout. So they're able to keep it in. Brewer to Kariya. Fakes, goes to Brewer. Now a one-timer from Boyes, came right back to him. Brad Boyes shoots one, and a save through a screen. Good stop by Javi Bull. That went right through the legs of Tkachuk, that shot. Here's Brewer at the line. Tkachuk front of the net. Kariya's long blast never got there. Boyes takes a look. Hawks have a Frazier out there without a stick now. They're going to work on him. Here's Boyes. Short side save and a beauty by Javi Bullen. Now McDonald rolled it loose. And still a man without a cue for the Hawks. That's Boland. I said Frazier. It's Boland without a stick. Here's Boys waiting. Goes to Correa. Then Boys had a shot. Good block there. By Sopel. Boys to Correa. Boys waiting. Shooting. Goal post. Hit the outside of the iron. Boys again. Kachuk is still at the front of the net, battling away. Here's Correa. Couldn't get it through. Boys. Correa to Boys. They got the box collapsed. Here's Boys. And he missed the net. And it's held in by McDonald. Boys again. Waits. Goes rink wide. They can't get rid of a shot. A pass and a broken up by Baldwin. Finally, they'll be able to get some fresh bodies out there. And the penalty is over.
Five blocks on that penalty kill. Three by Boland, two of them without a stick, and Brent Sopel with two. Outstanding job.
Oh, a fine penalty kill, particularly under the circumstances for the Hawks. And the Blues try to dump it in. That hit the backside of Perron. Campbell fires a long feed. That's an offside play. And a whistle. 8 minutes gone by, or seven and a half at least, in the second period. The Blues trying to draw a power play goal, missed by only an inch or two. Here's the Toyota Moving Forward schedule coming up. The Vancouver Canucks in the United Center tomorrow night. Remember, that's one of those great 6 o'clock starts, and that'll be a rested team there in Chicago waiting for the Hawks tonight. And Edmonton coming in on Wednesday. Next Saturday, the Red Wings will be in town. That game over WGN. And you see Versus and Young Olchek will have the game from Minnesota. Dave McClement. And it's taken away by Brian Campbell. Goes to the left side and Havlat with a little space. Coughlin. Hit hard, but got it to Sharp. Cutting in. Wait, got a man down. Oh, and a diving poke check the last moment. Prevented a shot as Weaver able to use his stick well while prone. Campbell to Sharp. Buckland trying to one-handed forward, but the Blues back in. McClement goes wide. Hey, McClement. He's into the corner. Perron center. Quick shot. Correa, but that one blocked. Good coverage by Aaron Johnson, who was right where he's supposed to be with his check. And it goes out of play.
A couple good defensive plays for the Hawks while shorthanded. That last one there by Aaron Johnson. But Patrick Sharp, Dustin Byfuglien makes the play here. He takes a hit, moves the puck up. Marty Havlat's going hard to the net, and Patrick Sharp just tries to throw on the brakes to allow Mike Weaver to go sliding by. But you know what? Stick on the ice. Desperation. You just never know. Outstanding play. Good idea by Patrick Sharp.
Seabrook. Good pass to Taves. Into the zone. The shot just off the mark. And the Blues look to start back. Perron got it in. Kane to Seabrook. Wants for Stieg. This for Stieg, got help from Jonathan Tay. Brewer squeezed him off along the wall. And the puck is going to be held in here by Seabrook. Boland from the corner. Ladd front of the net. Here's Keith for a long shot, not to the goal. Going off a leg to Correa. He cleared it ahead. TJ Oshie. She works against Keith. And Andrew Ladd. And checked by Keith Tkachuk. Held in by Jay McKee. Seabrook getting it back. Wants Boland on the right wing boards. Good touch pass finds Ladd. Scoops it ahead. Rolled away from Skilly though. Brad Boys to Andy McDonald. Trying to get away from Sopel. Good knot to Chuck. Got it through the goal mouth. McKee's long shot. Happy Boland gave a rebound. It came right back to him. And he hangs on.
Nikolai Haabibulin coming off the 4-1 win against the Phoenix Coyotes. The only goal, a power play goal by Peter Mueller, and a little bit of a rebound there, and good defensive coverage again. And it's the one thing with Joel Quenneville's teams in the past, the way they play defensively is they're very tight. All five guys, and most teams, Pat, play the same way. But again, I mean, you could throw a blanket out, and once the puck goes from that dangerous area in front of the net, it's quick to coverage out, make yourself look big. But there you can get a little bit of a idea of, so all five Blackhawk defenders, you know, within probably a, you know, a 40 or 50 foot area in front of Nikolai Haabibulin.
Now Henry put it deep. And Frazier works the boards. Here's a Burris shot attempt from a tough angle. It deflects to Campbell. Stepped away from one checker. Cleared it ahead. Johnson in behind to Frazier, who scored his first career goal the other night. Now Campbell to Johnson, a long shot off a leg to Burris. Good shift here for the Hawks fourth line. Burris has the puck in deep, put it in front. Legacy blocked that pass with his stick. And Jansen for the Blues has a problem. Eager took it away. Van Eager. Trying to pry it off the boards. The Blues clearing attempt held in by Aaron Johnson. Eager again. Hacks away. Came loose. Here's Campbell walking in. Lets it go. Put it up over crossbar. Held in by Hamlet, whose shot goes wide. Now Campbell. Got it back to Bufflin, a long blast, up off the glass. The puck has never left the zone, and the Hawks have made a wholesale change. How about that? Here's Sharp, in behind. Havlat takes a look. Campbell goes across Johnson to Campbell. And Freundich goes off a leg.
Got some tired hockey players out there for the Blues. The D can't get off.
And the Hawks get it right back in. Marty Havlat left it for Dustin Bufflin. Looking for Sharp, and it was out of his reach. And a clearing attempt exits the zone. You don't often see that, where a team can make a wholesale change and the puck never leave the offensive end. But that's how good the fourth line set up the next line to get out on the ice.
Against the Blues fourth line as well, Pat.
Now Sharp. Able to carry it into the zone. In front to Havlat. He stops. He shoots. Oh, Legacy got just enough. It missed the far post by less than a foot. Havlat looking to get back in. Or a Kane did. He shot it in deep. Now Jonathan Toews goes back to Brett Sopel, whose drive is blocked. Cleared to Kariya. They might have a two-on-one. Kariya has McDonald with him, a bouncing puck just over McClement's stick. McClement for Kariya, never got to him. Broken up by a sprawling Sopel, who got down to the ice to make that pass block. Hawks get back in for Steeg. Is rubbed off. But it's jammed loose, and the Blues have it. A clearing attempt held in by Sopel nicely. That's Sopel looking for his first shot on goal of the year. Able to send this one into the St. Louis end of the ice.
Seemed like Pat on that two-on-one for the Blues. Looked like Kariya never even thought about shooting. He just was almost telegraphed the play over to McClement.
Order was checked. Puck knocked away from Perron and Campbell out. Campbell gets the line. Went between teammates. Vlad for Skilly, but he couldn't field it in behind the goal. Hawks with a 2-0 lead here. Have allowed only 11 shots on goal so far to the Blues through 34 minutes of play. And the Hawks have only had 10. Johnson gets this one deep. Now Keith, the ever-present Duncan Keith.
Got the revolving door down at the defensive end of the Hawks bench.
Van Eager, quick shift right back for this Hawks fourth line that was really good last time they were out. So Quenneville Almost double shifting of air in this little sequence, but Brian Campbell with a long wrist shot, able to give the Hawks a 2-goal bulge. Joel Quenneville's had only a day and a half with his new team. How long does he think it'll take to figure out the strengths and weaknesses of his different players?
Well, I think you learn every day, and it's tough to say, but I think that there's enough ingredients here that we can make it work. We hope to, right off the bat here, we can have some success. But, I just think if we make progress and improvement in our skill and our team game, we'll find a way to win games.
Eddie, I would think the operative word for quite some time here, at least the next few weeks, is going to be work in progress, or at least the operative phrase.
Yeah, it's, again, it's talked about in the open, not only for Joel Quenneville, and again, I don't know if we've made mention, Pat, but Mark Bergevin, also part of the coaching staff now, along with John Torchetti and Mike Havlin. So a process for the coaching staff, especially Joel Quenneville, for not knowing a lot of these guys, but for the players as well, and certainly find out your niche awfully quick with new coach.
Here's Versteeg, a long snapshot. That's handled by Legacy. Well, you heard Patrick Kane in our first intermission talking with Josh. He said he felt like he was in a tryout. So, I mean, all these players have to do something to show the coach what they can do, and they're trying to impress the new guy.
And they all know who Joel Quenneville is. And
oh, yeah.
You see the talking to with head coach to second-year player Patrick Kane. A different voice, and like Joel said in the open, just not going to change a whole heck of a lot right away technically.
Let him go, but you know the one thing he was talking about in the open that we played for everybody, read and react, don't think. Here's Sharp, you know, it's the old I'm sure you heard this line, don't think you hurt the club.
Just like one time I was actually playing in Pittsburgh and went to a video after a day of a game, and former NHL defenseman Donnie Jackson was one of the assistant coaches in Pittsburgh, and right in front of everybody showing the video, and I made one of many dumb plays I made over my career, and he yelled, he says, what were you thinking, Olchek? What were you thinking? First thing that came to my mind is, I wasn't. Oh, you know what? But you're right. If you think it's right, do it. And
well, this game is just so fast, yeah. Now faster than ever, and you've got to react. When you think, what should I be doing, it's usually too late by that point. Skilly able to fend off a checker to maintain possession of it, and Jack Skilly got it to Boland. He bounced it forward. Ladd, quick shot. Oh, he just missed. Now Skilly. And it shot around the boards, a pinching Campbell to the corner. Andrew Ladd. Boland to the front of the net, turns it behind for it, wants it pass in front, it bounced away from Skilly, then Ladd missed it as well, and the Blues clear it out.
A good try there for this line of Skilly, Boland, and Ladd. Move the puck, move yourself. Dave Boland played his best game of the year in that win against the Phoenix Coyotes.
Sharp got a turnover, it wants Bufflin to the corner. Boys jammed it across to Keith Tkachuk. The 500 goal scorer. Now McKee. And it's taken away by Havlat. Steaming in. His shot goes off a leg. Tries again. It deflects. Here's Seabrook. Waits. And his pass is off the skate of Jay McKee. Four players battle along the boards. And the Hawks win the battle. Patrick Sharp with Bufflin now front of the net. Here's a bouncing puck over Eager's stick. And the Blues finally get it out. Here comes Boys, one on one. He's scored in every game so far for the Blues this year, but Boys a minus five in the first four Blues games, and he's minus one so far tonight. Now Seabrook's pass awry will go the length for an icing violation.
Well, Keith Tkachuk, as you mentioned, Pat, just a couple seconds ago, and into an empty net back on April 6th in Columbus.
He is now at 505, and he needs just two more goals. A long shot, they score! Javi Bulman gave a rebound, a face-off win for the Blues, and they cut the Hawks' lead in half.
The Hawks iced the puck. They were not allowed to make a change. The clean faceoff win, the quick shot, and Chris Porter scores his first National Hockey League goal. Got to the front of the net, a rebound, which we haven't seen a whole heck of a lot, Pat, from Nikolai Habibulin. And a big goal for the Blues there off the faceoff win.
And the Blues benefiting from one of the technical rule changes this year, Eddie, and I think it's a great rule. Icing, of course, you're not allowed to change players, but it used to be if it was time for a TV timeout, they would still take that TV timeout. Now they can't. If it yields a Blues goal, now we'll take the TV break. It's 2-1 Chicago late in the second.
Comcast has more HD than anyone and bundles to fit your needs. Watch local programming on demand. Comcast has a bundle for you. Call 1-888-4-BEST-TV.
Brett Sopel bouncing it to the neutral area. Brewer will throw it back in. Sopel ends it up the boards, and Versteeg able to maintain possession of it nicely, getting it out. Backus, in it goes. Campbell wants Versteeg on the left wing boards. A touch pass finds Toews. Now here's Sopel. He'll put it, he'll try to put it deep, but it's picked out of midair nicely. At the Blues defense.
Puck's got to get in. Can't do anything soft here, especially at the end of the period. Long changes here. That puck's, it's got to be 110%. It's got to be hard and in the zone to allow to make those changes, especially on that right side, because they have such a long way to go to the bench.
Keith to Seabrook. Sent into the Blue Zone. Legacy out to play it, so no icing here. And Ladd, a takeaway, threw it in front, and it's picked off by McDonald.
Well, I thought he might have thrown it at the net, Pat, maybe try to bounce it in off Legacy.
Here's Kariya, backhander, off the mark. And Brad Boys, taken away though by Seabrook. Now cleared along the boards at center, and Skilly finds Ladd. Boland to the corner, colliding with McKee. Jack Skilly against Andy McDonald, then Boys backhands it forward and out as we go to the final minute of the second period. The Hawks look to complete a change, getting it in. Kariya in for Oshie, driving to the goal. Good poke check by Sopel, preventing a shot. DJ Oshie working in behind. And Campbell trying to shoulder him out of the way. But the Blues dig it out. A wraparound and a save down low was Habibulin. Oshie again with it. Oshie centered. Kachuk had a roll away. Hawks look to counter. Might have a 3-on-2 if they hurry. Pavlat, oops, he forgot a little something. And the Blues back in. Perron waits, shoots. Goes over top of the net. Brewer's long flipper. Habibulin kicked it to Campbell, but he missed Bufflin with a pass attempt. Now McClement, who won the faceoff that led to the Blues' goal, beating Sharp on the draw, and the period comes to an end. The Blackhawks ended with only four shots in the second period. The Blues had nine. 15-11 for St. Louis through two, but there you see the score after 40 minutes of play. In Joel Quenneville's Hawks debut.
Blackhawks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by your local Hyundai dealer. What a day for a Hyundai. Go to MyChicagoHyundai.com. Brands, appliances, electronics, and more. And by Ford. Visit your Chicagoland Ford store and drive one.
Welcome you back to the Scott Trade Center here in St. Louis. The Hawks will take a 2-1 lead into the third period. And somewhere down there in the dark is the Blackhawk assistant coach Mike Haviland. They haven't turned the lights on here yet. But, Havi, thanks for joining us. Can you detect much of a difference in that Blackhawk locker room at all tonight?
Absolutely. I see the energy. Everybody's got their legs tonight and very focused tonight and, you know, from the cage out.
Hey, Havi, I want to go back to opening night if we can. Being a New York guy growing up in Hell's Kitchen, not too far away from Madison Square Garden, I know you being a big Ranger fan growing up, how was that for you to be around your family there and go back home and be on the bench in a game in Madison Square Garden?
Absolutely outstanding, Edzo. It was a fun day for my family, myself, and you know, just something I'll always remember. The first game in the NHL was in New York City, Madison Square Garden. Great to have family around, though. It was great.
Well, now they turn the lights on. We can see it. Folks, you see that smile? We've seen a lot of that from this man since he got to the behind an NHL bench. Congrats, Havi. We'll thank for a couple minutes.
Thanks, guys.
The guy who does a great job running the defense for the Chicago Blackhawks. He's the guy who changes up the D. And actually, I say he does a great job, but for the most part, he's only tapping three guys. Well, I mean, Duncan Keith is out there every other shift. He's got, you know, 19 minutes out of the first 40.
Here's how you do it. Left hand on one, right hand on the other, and the foot on the other one. That's all you, that's all you have to do.
Third period coming to you from Corona and Corona Light, official sponsor of the timeout. Relax and drink responsibly. 11 shots for Chicago through two, 14 for St. Louis. Well, the Hawks have the lead. And the third is almost underway. Now it is. And Weaver gives a little ground for St. Louis. Jackman. Gave it to Backus. Trying to bank that one. It appeared to the front of the net, but didn't get the bounce he wanted from the end boards. And Taves comes out. Jonathan Taves, who was given an assist properly on the first Hawk goal of the game tonight. Now Versteeg finds Campbell up on the play. Here's Kane for Campbell. Oh, good save by Legacy, post to post. Now again, the Hawks reorganize, and here's Brian Campbell. Weaver for the Blues. And a Buffalo near takeaway, but the Blues carry on. Curry into the zone, walks to the middle, a long shot, deflecting out the play.
Well, you called it, Pat, about the give and go with Kane and Campbell. Chris Versteeg gives it to Brian Campbell. He goes, I'll stop it right here. Here's the pass, but then watch what happens. He goes to the open ice. Give and go, and look at that pass. Saucer pass over the stick of Barrett Jackman. Campbell continued on. Unfortunately, wasn't able to elevate the puck. Manny Legacy going left to right, but good execution. Give and go, jump into those holes, and it's a tough assignment to try to cover a guy like Brian Campbell because he's everywhere, especially in the offensive zone.
Blues continue to dominate in the faceoff circle. They've gone 20 and 12 against the Hawks in 40 minutes. Doing wonderfully well in the faceoff department. In fact, that's what led to their lone goal. As Boys rings it around, and now a penalty coming up against the Blues. The stick might have come up and gotten sharp. That's what happened. They're going to determine whether it's a 2 or 4 minute infraction.
It's going to be interference. It's referee Eric Furlatt. It's the penalty to Andy McDonald for interfering with Patrick Sharp. Top of your screen. Inter- interference. Stick right in the face.
I don't know why he went low. I think they just misinterpreted the call. I think that's a high sticking call. But it doesn't make any difference. The Hawks on the power play. Both teams have been wonderful in keeping out of the box so far this game. This is just the second power play for Chicago. Kane was checked as he got to the line. But the Hawks able to keep it in. Brewer sandwiched on the end boards, and it goes out of play. Patrick Kane, a goal and an assist in the game, has been plus two in the first four games the Hawks played. Kane had one goal, one assist, and was a minus three. So the kid having a big night against the Blues tonight.
Playing on the line with Christopher Stieg and, of course, Jonathan Toews in the middle. Five on five.
The puck clear, but not out. Keith to Seabrook. He'll ring it around. Jackman took it, but was checked by Boland. Jammed along the board. Duncan Keith able to find Brent Seabrook. He couldn't quite execute the kick to the stick. Versteeg back in. Now Havlat with a quick shot off the arm, a Legacy bouncing puck. Havlat and a save, rebound, another save by Legacy. Three big stops there for the Blues, Matt Miner.
Good entry. It was started by Brent Seabrook in a neutral zone. Chris Versteeg changing sides, going from the left wing boards over to the right, and then Havlat staying with those opportunities. Three good chances.
Kane dropped it to Campbell. Now a long shot, didn't get to the net. Bufflin. And then it was shot high and wide, and the puck cleared. Half a minute for the power play. Campbell working a point along with Sharp here. The tail end of this power play. Campbell gains the zone, dropped it to Kane right up the middle. Here's the shot. He scores! Patrick Kane, his second goal, third point of the night. Off the crossbar and in. 3-1.
Watch the room that Brian Campbell has entering the zone. The Blues back up way too far. This allows Brian Campbell to get the zone. Look at, nobody on him. He gets the blue line, and then Patrick Kane comes on that second wave. He slices through and elevates the puck. What a shot. Beautiful shot by Patrick Kane. Head up, head up. Legacy goes down, puck in behind, and that's one happy human. Puck's up by two.
Oh, a big goal for the kid on the power play to give the Hawks at least a little breathing room.
That's what speed will do through the neutral zone, especially the guy with Campbell. Pat pushes you back, but it almost just seemed that the Blues were. And I saw the door open, and on one replay, had a great look. It looked like the door was open, so maybe they were in the middle of a change. But still, though, somebody's got to stand up and not allow Campbell to get the blue line. And then here comes Kane in that second wave.
Burrish goes down, Tkachuk jammed loose, Perron missed it, and the Hawks have control. Andrew Ladd. Burrish against Jackman. Ladd. Back to Jordan Hendry. Across to Brent Sopel, whose long shot is blocked by Keith Tkachuk. And TJ Oshie rolled it loose to David Perron. Into the zone on Hendry, who used his stick nicely. And now a penalty coming up. Oh, the Blues power play will get a chance.
It's going to be on Jordan Hendry, where he gets the stick, right between the legs of David Perron and head athletic trainer Ray Barilli is checking out.
That is a double minor. That's a 4-minute penalty given to Hendry. So a major opportunity here for the vaunted Blues power play. Apparently we're having a few video problems on our way back to Chicago. They are working on it, and we'll try to get everything fixed as soon as we can. We hope you're able to stay with us. On the Blues power play is Brewer, and a stand-up save, and hit the goal post! Oh, Javi Bula got just enough and then hit the crossbar, but stayed out of the net. McDonald checked by Duncan Keith. Keith won the puck, then Tkachuk got it back. And it's going to be taken by Brewer. And time now for Keith to take a look. Clearing.
That opportunity for Eric Brewer, Pat, was a direct result of another faceoff win. You talked about the dominating numbers through two periods for the Blues. Direct result, one faceoff, shot to the net. Good break for the Hawks off the post.
Now the Hawks take control and clear it. Let me make sure I pass along the penalty properly. It was a 4-minute spearing infraction given to Jordan Hendry. Now Perron had it taken away by Boland. And Versteeg has control of it. The first minute has gone by in this 4-minute Blues power play.
Almost a giveaway there by Manny Legacy. Good job there by Dave Boland.
Now Pollock. Squeezed off by Keith. Duncan Keith got spun around. Pollock got it back. It missed Oshie to Seabrook with time. Oh, bad break. He shot it into the Hawk. Oh, that hit Troy Parchment. I think the Hawk player's ducking out of the way, and that caught the trainer Parchment, but seems as if he'll be all right.
Looks like Mikey Havlin was ducking as well, and it ended up hitting Parchie right in the arm. He looks to be all right, but there's that faceoff win. Andy McDonald, Korea to Brewer, the shot. Javi Bulin has no idea where it was, and it just goes up and over. Watch the top right part of your screen. Kind of jumps at it and right off the right post and crossbar.
Minute and a half killed off against this St. Louis power play in Korea. Cleared it into the zone. McDonald with a ring around. Javi Bulin wanted to play it, missed it. And Sopel able to jam it loose, and the Hawks get it out. Quick change for Chicago. Korea forced to turn at center, dropped it to Brewer. He gets the line. Brewer pulled it to the forehand, couldn't get it to the net. The Hawks collapsed beautifully that time. And the puck held in by the Blues. Korea with a long shot, not getting through. And it's held in right to the front of the net. Here's the boys, and he shot it wide. Now taken by McDonald, his chance. That didn't get to the net. And chased down by Versteeg with time, clearing.
Boy, what patience there by Brad Boyce. He waited out Brent Sopel. Walked to the front of the net, and Robbie Bullen got a piece of that.
Perron back in. Oshie dropped it back. Pollock going rink wide. Now they have Perron dropping it out to the line. A long shot by Weaver, deflected into the corner. Chased down by Sharp. He cleared it.
Nice penalty kill here, Pat. The Hawks have been able to clear the puck about three or four times between the two defensemen. They've been winning those battles and knowing where the open ice is, shooting it down 200 feet.
Perron pushed it forward. Backus chipped it in deep. Now it comes right to Adam Burrish, whose backhand pass is off the mark to Pollock. Stand up save, Javi Bulin. Pollock goes into the deep slot. Weaver got it to the side of the goal. Perron waits, tried to center, came back to him. Perron tried to bank it in off Javi Bulin. That didn't work. Now held in by Roman Pollock. Moves across the line. Now they have Backus to the front of the net. Couldn't get it to him. Held in at the line by Wagner. Up the board, David Perron. McDonald front of the net. Or at least he pulled away from it now. And the puck corralled by Sopel. With time, nobody challenged Sopel at all. He took his sweet time nicely.
Taking his sweet time after a couple of good blocks again by Brent Sopel. I got him down for 6 unofficially blocked shots so far.
But Havilat takeaway, a puck off a skate into the glove of Legacy, and what a PK job turned in by the Chicago Blackhawks to maintain the two-goal lead they were given on Patrick Kane's second of the night.
Time now for our 4 great saves, and there's been a bushel full by Nikolai Javi Bulin. getting some help from his defense. They've done an outstanding job. Brent Sobel, Dave Bolin, while shorthanded. As you mentioned, Pat, a great penalty kill, a four-minute penalty kill. With a penalty by Jordan Hendry. And nicknamed the Boulin Wall, has been solid again here. The Hawks up by two.
No bricks missing in that wall tonight. All right, here's Jackman. Up the right side with it, and Hino tapped it out of there. This will be an offside play if and when McClemmon touches it. That happened.
Well, great seats are available now at ChicagoBlackhawks.com for all home games, including tomorrow night, 6 o'clock against the Vancouver Canucks, and Wednesday, the 22nd of October, against the Edmonton Oilers. In addition to being available at ChicagoBlackhawks.com, tickets may also be purchased by calling Ticketmaster at 312-559-1212 or in person at the United Center box office. Don't forget tomorrow night. Welcome back to you. You get one of those welcome back Pat Foley pins. First 10,000 people through the United Center turnstiles.
Vancouver in town, a 6 o'clock start. Now that one tomorrow. All right, now the Hawks have Versteeg. Put it on Taves' stick. Taves with a wrist shot. Short side save by Legacy. The puck came right back to him on a Kane hack. Now Taves. And Patrick Kane is taken down in the corner. The Blues get the puck out of the zone as Wagner worked hard to make that happen. But back in it comes for Versteeg. Kane to the net, quick shot, and a save by Legacy. Perron able to kick it forward. Here he comes. David Perron crisscrossing with Tkachuk. Walks in, shoots, and he goes high off the glass for that one. Game back to Tkachuk, and his pass goes out of the zone.
Boy, Barrett Jackman left the zone awfully early. Good break there for the Hawks, who took a advantageous bounce for the Blues.
Oshie for Tkachuk, he scored! T.J. Oshie got it to Keith Tkachuk, a one-timer from point blank, 3-2.
Well, Pat, we've talked a lot about it, the execution of the Hawks on give and go. And Keith Tkachuk makes the play. He starts it, he gets it to David Perron, and then he goes hard to the net. And Oshie just throws it out in front of the net before Brent Sobel can deny Keith Tkachuk. It almost seemed that that pass was in between the stick blade of Sobel and his skates. And then Tkachuk just goes hard to the net. Goal number 6 on the season.
He has scored in every game the Blues have played this year, all 5 starts for St. Louis. And now Keith Tkachuk within 1 goal in his career of the legendary great Jean Béliveau. For 37th place in the all-time list. So now the Hawks have Burris dropping it back. Johnson's long drive easily stopped by Manny Legacy. We've reached the halfway point of the third. It's a 1-goal Chicago lead. Welcome back to St. Louis. Here are the U.S. Cellular text poll results. I don't know who'd be surprised by that. Hawks fans think the Hawks are going to win the season series.
We appreciate the 7,000 texters tonight, Patrick.
But some work to be done here with still half the third period remaining. And the lead has been cut to 1. And the Blues get control again off a draw, but the clearing attempt held in by Campbell. And out of the zone, it's taken by Havlat to Seabrook. Seabrook will scoop it deep. Havlat against Jackman on the boards. Hawks dig it out, but Bufflin couldn't squeeze through traffic. And Keith chasing back. Seabrook's long bank pass was there for Ladd, but rolled away from him. And back comes Oshie. TJ Oshie trying to get around to check. A couple neat maneuvers, but could not beat Duncan Keith's shoulder. Now Perron. Knocked loose and out. And finally, Ladd got it deep, and everybody having trouble getting that puck to settle down.
A stick of fork in it.
Yeah. Ladd in the corner, but it's knocked loose to Tkachuk. And the Blues come away. Now Perron's long shot. Oh, good save through a screen by Javi Bulin. And the Hawks Skilly the other end. His long wrister padded away by Legacy. And now Brewer for St. Louis. Sending it up the right wing side. Bounced away from Porter, who's got a goal. Came in front. Here's the drive. Oh, McClement didn't miss by much. That was just over the crossbar. And now picked up by Aaron Johnson. Dropping to Brian Campbell. Here comes Patrick Kane. They've got four back across the line. He squeezes in. Going to draw a penalty. Here's a shot and a save by Legacy. Rebound. The Blues get it. The Hawks will go to the power play. And Patrick Kane, with his brilliant skill, they had four men across the line. How did he not only drive his way through, but draw a penalty?
The ability to push people back and just knifing through so easy. And then the hook in from behind. But Andy Murray, the penalty will be on Barrett Jackman. Andy Murray was up on top of the bench, Pat, when the Blues had the puck in the Hawks zone. He thought that Taves kind of reached around a little bit and dropped that free hand. No penalty called, and now the Hawks get a huge opportunity on this power play.
A power play goal of the game for the Hawks. These special teams have not been in a lot of evidence tonight. Neither team's had a bunch of chances, but the Hawks get in sharp to Taves. Trouble getting possession of it. Locked up with McClement on the boards. It's kicked loose. Here's Campbell. Now they got Buffalo in front of the net. There's Taves going back to Campbell. Then Sharp walked in. Center quick shot. Blocked by McKee. Into the glove of Legacy. And he's able to hang on.
Good puck movement there from Campbell to Sharp. Through the box. Through the four penalty killers. Watch the movement. Patrick Sharp throws it right back the other way. And the opportunity for Jonathan Taves. Good strength here down low by Manny Legacy. Look at his left pad. Never moves it. Out on top. Does not allow Patrick Kane. If he's in deeper, that allows Kane to get that puck and be able to elevate the puck. But since he was out, really cut it down. Good job there all the way around.
And McDonald gets control of it. Going to work two on two. And that's an offside play. Stasny couldn't hold up.
Saw Jonathan Taves with that good opportunity. The one thing that's evident to me so far, Pat, is that Joel Quindle has really not used Jonathan Taves while shorthanded. He's not been one of his guys. He did use him on that four-minute kill, but early in the game, he did not kill any penalties. So just something, a little thing that, you know, maybe Joel Quindle looks at Jonathan Taves.
Now Marty Havlat was checked. McDonald to Brewer, clearing. 45 seconds for the Blackhawks power play. And Keith, here's a good hustling job to get back, trying to get that puck back up the ice as fast as he can. Taves packed it into the corner. McKee colliding with Taves and Havlat with the puck. Now taken by Brian Campbell. Wants Patrick Kane. Havlat to the front of the net. Here's Taves. He chipped it for Havlat. Taken down before he could make a pass. It's held in by Campbell. Now Johnson walking in. Dropped it to Campbell. It was rolling on him. Broke his stick as he tried that shot. And fortunately Johnson there to pick up the puck. And that finishes the Blues penalty. Both teams at full strength now. Down to 5.5 left in regulation. Johnson into the zone. Center, Taves kicked at it. That was sticked away by Legacy. And it's picked up by Brewer. Pollock dumping it. Duncan Keith back. And now Adam Burrish. Ejected center. Comes loose to the Blues. McDonald stepping in. Brewer to the net. McDonald right in. Shoots. Didn't get to the goal. Oh, what a save by Javi Bolin on a Brewer hack. And it bounced over Pollock's stick.
Wow, what a stop. Desperation. Brewer jumping into the play. Defenseman trying to create some chances. McDonald to the net. Big body in front. And like Brewer, great stop.
Ball through a check. His pass went off the skate of Seabrook, though. And Bufflin got it back. And muscles his way through a couple of checkers. Gets it into the zone. And gave Havlat a tweener. Back comes Pollock. That was Oshie moving in. Oshie trying to get in front of the net. Oh, good stick by Javi Bolin preventing a problem. Bufflin chased his dump and got it into the corner. Havlat to the front of the net. Now pulls off for a change. And the Blues come away. Perron to Oshie. Carried on. Taken by Weaver. Quick shot. That's fluttered. Here's a shot. And a save by Javi Bolin. Oh, big stop on a rebound stuff attempt, and the puck is frozen. Now, nobody wants to take a foolish penalty here, but it has been, particularly in the first period, a very physical affair. You can imagine tempers are getting a little bit shorter, but Nikolai Javi Bolin with a couple of strong stops to keep his team in front.
Well, tomorrow night, Jonathan Toews and the Hawks will take on Roberto Luongo and the Vancouver Canucks in high definition. Coverage starts with Blackhawks pregame live. Blackhawks Canucks tomorrow night, 5:30, right here on Comcast Sportsnet.
4 minutes remaining. Joel Quenneville has sent Colin Frazier on the ice to try to finally win a draw in a defensive zone. McDonald's been great on the faceoffs, and Frazier did his job. Seabrook a hoister, Frazier and Ladd and Burrish go off for a quick change. So they execute what they were sent out to do. And the Blues will have to come from their own end. Brad Boys gains the line. Stripped of it there. And a Chicago counterattack. Versteeg to the backhand, trying to muscle his way in. Could not on Brewer. Kane checked. But he's got the puck. Patrick Kane, now Seabrook. Sends it across to Keith, tries a long one, and hit traffic on the way. Brian Campbell sending it in. The Hawks will counter a Blues change with one of their own. 3 minutes left in regulation. 3-2 in favor of the Hawks. Dustin Bufflin. A hoister and Legacy wanted to play that, but Havlat hustling in, so it'll be a defensive zone draw for St. Louis.
If you just take for granted, if you're Marty Havlat or anybody, Pat, as you mentioned, puck goes into the goaltender, if you just pull up right away, Legacy's the type of guy or want to keep the play going and try to maybe catch you in between, catch you napping a little bit. A smart play, as you pointed out, by Havlat.
Now Havlat, the puck taken back by the Blues. Jay McClements, bank pass, nicely broken up by Johnson. Barrett Jackman will try to get things underway. Now it's dumped into the Hawks zone. Back has picked it up. Had a tough angle shot that Johnson blocked. Stasny, whose ice time has been somewhat minimal tonight, gets it into the corner. There's Backus, and the puck taken away, but not. Oh, it did get out. Up over the stick of Wagner. Down to 2 minutes remaining in the third. And Pollock banked it forward. Porter works a give and go. He's got it. Porter's shot, though, blocked by Burrish. Adam Burrish squeezed to the boards, and now the Blues reorganize. Brewer rolled it in. McDonald checked by Seabrook. Eric Brewer, the D-man, is way in behind the Hawk goal, trying to make something happen. He's got the puck. Brewer. And there goes Legacy to the bench. Six attackers with a minute and a half remaining. And this puck out of the zone. That's an offside play. Now, why is that not an intentional offside?
Well, the definition there of maybe just anticipating maybe that the referee or the linesman didn't see him because he used his glove in order to maybe protect his vision a little bit. That's the only thing I can think of, Pat, why it would not have been intentional. Left part of your screen there, and linesman, perfect positioning. Not sure if it was Brad Lazarowicz or Johnny Murray, but must have had his carrots for lunch this afternoon. Well, Chicago Blackhawks games are a great idea for your next group outing. Find out about what group discounts and fundraising opportunities by contacting the Chicago Blackhawks sales department at 312-455-7000. Get a group together and come on down to the United Center tomorrow night. Hawks and Canucks, 6 o'clock start. First 10,000 fans in attendance will receive a welcome back Pat Foley pin.
Don't scare him away.
Courtesy of the fine folks at AT&T. Is that reversible, that pin? Or what?
So fortunately, there's only a microphone on it. Joel Quenneville going for his 439th career victory. And the winningest coach in the history of the Blues, 307 of his wins came in this city, where he enjoyed a very good eight-year run behind their bench.
One of the players on the Blues told me it's the best coach he's ever played for in his National Hockey League.
Oh, you'll hear
career.
That a lot from guys who played for this fella. 75 seconds left. And there goes Legacy again. Six attackers. Tkachuk works his way in deep, his pass deflecting. McDonald tried to center one, that one picked off, but Keith couldn't advance it, and it deflects out of play with a minute remaining.
See if Joel Quenneville throws back Colin Frazier. He won the faceoff on the last side here to the left of Nikolai Haviboul, and see if he goes back with Colin Frazier to take that draw. Looks like he's thrown out Havlat, Sharp, and Burrish.
So Sharp will step here in here against Boys. And the Hawks get control of it, but Seabrook couldn't get it out. Oshie leaves for Tkachuk. Now Kariya sends it across to Brewer. He has to go around the perimeter. Boys is front of the net. Now bouncing puck to McDonald. Boys now and Tkachuk at the front. Here's Kariya. He's centered. McDonald on his backhand. It's blocked. Burrish kicked it in behind. Now it's taken by Tkachuk. Half a minute to go. Tkachuk to Kariya. And a takeaway by Seabrook. He hoisted it out of there. And will it go far enough for icing? It will. Patrick Sharp must have been tired. I really was surprised he didn't try to chase that down to save the whistle, but it'll be a defensive zone draw for Chicago.
Got some tired guys out there right now.
Seconds remaining
on both sides.
Yeah, 3-2 in favor of the Hawks. Now Burrish and Boys will go for the draws. Burrish gonna try just fire it over to the boards, and the Blues get it. Kariya couldn't get it to the goal. Hacked loose. Here's McDonald. He scored. Andy McDonald, after another St. Louis faceoff win, has tied the game in the final seconds.
Well, the faceoff win Keith Tkachuk standing in front of the net, Duncan Keith right in front, two Blues to either side. The quick shot, and see if this changes directions. Oh, off the left shin pad of Duncan Keith, past Nikolai Haviboul. Should be Andy McDonald's goal. Brad Boys won the faceoff. Hawks weren't able to clear. Tied up.
So a two-goal Blues comeback here in the third. In the second half of the third period, it is McDonald's goal. Hawks move in. Mufflin could get his stick free. And we will go to extra time in St. Louis tonight. The Blues, who were down by two with half a period to play, have managed to get a point out of the game. Ed Olczyk will take us through the game summary, how we got to this point.
So 40 seconds in, Christopher Stieg with the shot. Patrick Kane going hard to net. The Hawks with a 1-0 lead. Big rebound. You want to score? Get to the net. We head to the second period. Brian Campbell, quick little wrist shot. Nice pass there through the neutral zone by Patrick Kane. The Hawks with a 2-0 lead. But then a face-off win by Jay McClement. Chris Porter's first National Hockey League goal. 2-1 Hawks lead. And Brian Campbell to Patrick Kane right off the crossbar. What a shot. The Hawks with a 3-1 lead. And then TJ Oshie, one of the hottest goal scorers in all the National Hockey League. The Blues cut it to 3-2. And then when the goaltender out, Andy McDonald off the left knee of Duncan Keith. And threes are wild as we head out of the third period into overtime.
Well, this one, Joe Quenneville's been on both sides of this rivalry, and of course he hasn't had the full experience of Chicago, from the Chicago side against St. Louis, but it's always great when these teams play, isn't it?
Even back in the days when you'd be able to patrol the ice over at the old Checker Dome, people within, seemed like 6 inches back when they were standing right behind you in the old barn, but as Nikolai Abibulin's over by the bench getting a fresh bottle of water there and heading back to his crease.
All right, four skaters aside into extra time tonight. Johnson and Campbell on the back end for the Hawks. Taves and Kane up front. Campbell will be forced to turn.
Nice job there by TJ Oshie.
Oshie and Correa for the Blues. Here's Taves, a long wrister. Legacy gave a rebound, but Wagner with control of it. Wagner and the Brewer, the two D-men for St. Louis. And Brewer earning his keep tonight. He's played just under half the game up until now. Oshie, he's trying to give it to Correa, but he was heading off. Both teams make some changes. Here's Wagner. He pulls up. Who's the late man? They couldn't get it to him, and Havlat sends Keith up the ice. Duncan Keith spins it back to Seabrook, and a good pad save by Legacy. Keith again to Seabrook. Center to Havlat. Couldn't pull it to the backhand cleanly. Grant Seabrook to Duncan Keith. A long slap shot. Short side save by Legacy. Sharp work on the boards, won the puck. Havlat to Keith to Seabrook. Duncan Keith tries a shot that's blocked to Jackman. Oh, and Havlat got caught, gonna be a 2-on-1. Here come the Blues. McDonald, little save by Javi Bolin. And the goal knocked off the moorings.
Well, a couple good opportunities for the Hawks. You mentioned it, Pat. Havlat gambled and lost. And then Andy McDonald. There you see Barrett Jackman going hard into the net, knocking the net. Had a little help there from Brent Seabrook as well, and I'm a little surprised that this faceoff comes outside the zone. Because Seabrook was the one that pushed Jackman into the net. Hawks will take that break.
Kachuk want to draw, pulled it forward, gonna draw penalty. As Happy Bullen makes a save, a 4-on-3 power play after another St. Louis faceoff victory.
Well, Keith Tkachuk plans ahead that he's going to go ahead on his faceoff. There's Jonathan Toews. He realizes that he's on his backhand. He gets body position. All he does is chip the puck between the legs of Toews. He gets body position, and then the stick of Toews in behind. And a good stop there by Javi Bullen. But a heads-up play there by the veteran.
Well, the game on the line against this Blues power play in the 4-on-3. Korea goes down low. McDonald to Korea. McDonald walks, shoots, and a save by Heavy Bullet right through the paint and went. Tkachuk picked it up. Boys to Korea. Four forwards on the ice for the Blues. And Paul Korea moves in. Down low, McDonald. Tkachuk front of the net. There's Korea to McDonald. Shooting! Heavy Bullet with the right arm. And the puck to the Hawks. They'll clear.
I don't think he realized he had that. He was kind of, you know, looking on his left, looking on his right. And as long as he doesn't look behind, that's a good thing.
Back comes Korea. Bad boys. Paul Korea again. Tkachuk will set up shop top of the crease. McDonald to Korea. Boys. Now McDonald. Touch pass. Oh, too hot to handle. Went right through Kachuk's legs. Boys to Korea, the one-timer off the glass and chased by Birch, but couldn't get it before Boys did. Still 45 for the power play. Korea, and that's a block nicely by Campbell. Here's Tkachuk now in front to Korea. The drive, Javi Bullen fought it off through a screen by McDonald. Here's Korea. McDonald waiting, centering. Boys goes back to Korea. There's McDonald. Couldn't get it to Tkachuk. Now put it in front. Boys got nothing on that shot. And Sokol got it out. Just one more quick rush on this Blues man advantage. Perron carries the mail. Oshie to the net. Perron's pass broken up. Now chased down by Duncan. Keith, he spun back into traffic trouble. Needs help from Seabrook. He's able to jam it loose. The Hawk penalty over. It's four skaters aside. Here's Kane back on the ice. Oops. His drop pass off the mark. Perron back in. Fighting through a Toews hit. Quick shot. Good save, Javi Bullen. Oshie goes back to Brewer. Into the final minute of the game. Here's a long shot. Blocked. And finally the Hawks come away. Ryan Campbell leads him in against Brewer. Campbell to spinorama. Now waits. He'll go. I thought he was going to give it to Johnson. Did not. Hangs on. Centered. That pass was behind Patrick Kane.
Boy, that was a good job there by Eric Brewer. Just staying with Campbell. Not trying to get. Try to cover two and three guys. Good job defensively there by the veteran blue liner.
Now Brad Boys. Jackman carried on, around a check into the zone. Barrett Jackman, shot from a bad angle. Taken now by Johnson. Down to 10 seconds remaining. Here's a lead for Havlat moving in. Trying to dance around a check, could not, as Korea was back and stayed with him. Now, here's the Keelong shot into the glove of Javi Bullen, and we will go to a shootout in Missouri. Well, Nikolai Javi Bullen and the Blackhawk penalty killers tested often by the Blues red hot power play.
Well, giving the penalty killers an awful lot of credit, and of course your best penalty killer has to be Nikolai Javi Bullen. A couple real good stops, and it seemed that Paul Kariya and Andy McDonald were the key guys on that opportunities on that 4-on-3 in overtime. So some great stops there. We get an official number on shots, Pat.
Six saves shots in overtime for that man.
Big time save. Well, after the game, stick around for Smirnoff Vodka Blackhawks post-game live. Get all the highlights, post-game reaction and analysis with the Chuck Meister and Steve Conroy. Don't miss Smirnoff Vodka's Blackhawks post-game live immediately after the game on Comcast Sportsnet. That's right away, by the way. Don't forget tomorrow night, Hawks and Canucks at United Center. I'm sure the Canucks were out enjoying a fabulous dinner somewhere in some of the great restaurants in downtown Chicago.
That starts off a busy week for the Hawks. Edmonton is in on Wednesday night, and then Detroit is in Saturday. By the way, the Wednesday night is an 8 o'clock start. Saturday, when Detroit is in town, that is a 7:30 game. And tomorrow night, 6 o'clock against Roberto Luongo and the Sedins and the Vancouver Canucks. Well, the Blackhawks are going to go with the entire kid line as the shooters in this shootout. We've been told Kane, Taves, and Versteeg.
And the one thing with Manny Legacy, Pat, is if you go quick on him, he comes out quite a bit. And then he pushes back and goes back quickly into his net. I was talking with Marty Havlat about this before the game, and he made mention of how Legacy is, and just again in conversation, it's almost like one of those where a guy like Legacy, if he goes back so fast, should just put on your brakes, let him slide in deep, and then as you're stopping, just elevate the puck because he goes down. I'd say maybe Marty Havlat maybe shares some of that knowledge with the youngsters that are to this point in the shootout.
All right, here's your first shooter, McDonald. Moves in to the backhand. Oh, and he missed an open net. Andy McDonald stick handled around Javi Bullitt, had a 6x4. Missed it.
He just shanks it. Goes right through the crease. Look at this. He just turned his hands over. That's exactly what happened. Instead of opening up, Pat, the blade, he just shanked it.
Patrick Kane in the bottom of the first. A chance for the Hawks here in the shootout. Legacy out to meet him. Kane, stick handling, and Legacy able to snuff the backhand.
Well, two games ago, Patrick Kane tried to go top glove here. This time he goes forehand back on net, able to elevate the puck, but you see Legacy takes away the bottom of the net. So if you're gonna make a move, you have to elevate the puck.
Brad Boys. Next up for Andy Murray's team. He moves in quickly. Shoots, he scored. Beat the glove of Javi Bullitt, and Boys has the Blues in front of the shootout.
Well, that little fake. The fake with the blade. Javi Bullitt went down right there. Goes top shelf.
Jonathan Taves is next up for Joel Quenneville. Taves picks up a little speed. And he tied the shootout going five hole.
Straight in, head up. You called it, Pat, right between the legs, under the blade of the stick. One quick little stick handle.
All right, Paul Kariya. You see his magic in the shootout, a 50% conversion rate. And Kariya goes a little wide. Stick handle, and Javi Bullitt with the left skate. And now a chance to win it for Versteeg and the Hawks. So the old man of this kid line at the age of 22, Chris Versteeg, has never done this at this level or in front of this many people. A chance to win it for his team. Versteeg is snuffed by Legacy. We'll go to extra innings now in the shootout.
Chris Versteeg holds, not able to elevate the puck when he goes forehand, backhand, a little pump of the left leg. Good stop there by Legacy.
DJ Oshie, next up for the Blues. Going right up the middle. The stick handle, and what a maneuver. Oshie, spectacular. And it's a one-goal lead for St. Louis.
Good speed, couple fakes, and looked like Hobby Bullen actually went for a poke check there and missed it.
And now Havlat must convert to keep the Hawks alive in the shootout. Marty Havlat, let's see if he does what he said to Olczyk that he might. Legacy way out, Havlat. He did slow up, but he couldn't lift it. And Manny Legacy with a stop to win it for St. Louis.
They did everything, Pat. Just did not get it up under the bar. I think he got in a little bit too tight. And the reaction from the Blues bench. Well, you see
Andy Murray wasn't even watching.
Right. From experience,
yeah.
I never watched a shootout. Never. I waited for the reaction of the crowd, either for or against.
The Lexus pursuing perfection player of the game tonight, Patrick Kane, figured in every Blackhawk goal, scoring two, assisting on the other.
That line was good tonight, Pat.
Oh, boy. Well, they were all picked for the shootout, so Quenville
obviously
agreed with what you just said. And that goal you just saw put the Hawks up by 3-1. Midway, or I should say early in the third, it stayed that way to the midpoint of the third period, but a two-goal Blues rally. With the tying goal coming with only 14 seconds remaining. And St. Louis able to come from behind and win the game in the shootout. Our next game on Comcast Sportsnet. Vancouver is in the United Center tomorrow night at 6 o'clock for the puck drop. Stick around, the Smirnoff Vodka Blackhawks postgame live coming up with Chuck Garfine and Steve Conroy. Now for Eddie Olczyk and our Comcast crew, Pat Foley, hoping you enjoyed the broadcast in spite of the outcome. St. Louis 4, Chicago 3 in a shootout. See you tomorrow night. So long, everyone.